BBC Red Button. BBC Red Button is a branding used for digital interactive television services provided by the BBC, and broadcast in the United Kingdom. The service has replaced CFAX, the BBC's analog teletext service. The service was launched in September 1999 as BBC Text. It was relaunched in November 2001 under the BBC brand and operated under this name until late 2008, when it was rebranded as BBC Red Button. The Red Button name refers to the common interface on remote controls for digital televisions and set-top boxes, a red push button which launches digital teletext services. Although initially marketed as a spectacular new form of television, by 2008 this had given way to positioning if as everyday apostrophe. This was due in part to the institutional landscape of television in the UK. BBC Text originally launched on digital terrestrial services in September 1999. And was later introduced on satellite and cable platforms. In the first phase, the service was created using content migrated from the existing analog teletext service, CFAX. A digital text service had been available since the launch of digital terrestrial television in November 1998, but the BBC text service was not publicly launched until November 1999, due to a lack of availability of compatible set-top boxes. BBC text was considerably more advanced than CFAX, in that it offered a richer visual interface, with the possibility of photographic images and designed graphics, as opposed to CFAX graphics which were composed of simple blocks of color. BBC Text also enabled channel association, the ability for the user to retain their selected television channel visible in one section of the screen whilst viewing the text service, in contrast to CFAX, which could only be viewed as a full-screen display, or as a semi-transparent overlay, i.e. opaque blocks of color on top of the television channel, with the black background now transparent, not translucent blocks of color with a translucent black background, above the television picture. The original text service had no return path, this being made available in later phases. BBC Text pioneered an early form of on-demand interactive television, called Enhanced TV. During the 1999 Wimbledon Championships, the BBC presented a service which allowed viewers to select a video stream of different matches, and access additional information such as player profiles, scores and interactive quizzes. Although the experimental service was publicly available, there were no digital set-top boxes or receivers available on the market which could decode the signal, and the service was only presented to the public via BBC demonstrations using prototype receivers. The BBC brand launched in November 2001 and was conceived as a cohesive multi-platform brand name for all the BBC's digital interactive services, encompassing the corporation's digital teletext, interactive television and website services. According to the BBC, the IMC stood for interactivity as well as innovation. The various services all took on a common interface device, an iBar branded with the BBC logo, which sought to emphasize the brand across different technologies by providing similar navigation. For example, the BBC website, which had previously been called BBC Online, took on the BBC brand from 2001, displaying an iBar across the top of every page, offering a category-based navigation, categories, TV, radio, communicate, where I live, AZ Index, and a search. Similarly, BBC Interactive Television Services all offered a horizontal iBar along the bottom of television screens, with four color-coded interactions linked to the four color buttons on TV remote controls. After 3 years of consistent use across different platforms, the BBC began to drop the BBC brand gradually. On May 6, 2004, the BBC website was renamed bbc.co.uk, after the main URL used to access the site. Interactive TV services continued under the BBC brand until late 2008. Today, the broadcaster's online video player, the BBC iPlayer, reflects the branding legacy by retaining an i prefix in its branding. In June 2013, a HD version of BBC Red Button was launched for the summertime. It closed on November 25, 2013 after the 50th anniversary of Doctor Who. It returned each year along with the other BBC Red Button channels as a temporary channel for the duration of the Wimbledon tennis tournament. On March 26, 2018, CBBC HD began its downtime and the relaunch of BBC Red Button HD took place to cover the 2018 Commonwealth Games. It was added on Sky on channel 981 and Freeview channel 602 on April 3, 2018 and closed on April 16, 2018 after the Games had concluded. From 2008, The BBC gradually began to drop the BBC name from its digital interactive TV services also, replacing it with the name BBC Red Button. The BBC logo continued in on-screen presentation for some time. In November 2008, the BBC celebrated 10 years of the digital interactive TV service. BBC Connected Red Button launched in December 2012 on Virgin TiVo and on some Freeview and Freesat smart TVs in December 2013. The service is a composite IP and broadcast service and may be the future of Red Button on internet-connected televisions. The service was renamed BBC Red Button Plus in April 2015. It launched with an updated brand. BBC Red Button is available on all digital television platforms in the UK, including digital cable through Virgin Media, digital satellite through Sky and Freesat and digital terrestrial television through Freeview. It is also available in Ireland through Sky. On Freeview, interactivity does not permit users to submit data such as answering questions in a quiz or requesting video on demand, as the platform does not provide a return path. BBC Red Button currently provides one video stream to all platforms, which can be accessed directly from Freeview Channel 601, Freesat Channel 981. Sky Channel 980 and Virgin Media Channel 991, however the feed is standard definition only. One advantage of the feed is the DVR ability, as the conventional red button interaction restricts DVR record, pause, rewind functions, and is a major caveat for many. It is currently unknown if the BBC plans to reintroduce a permanent high-definition service of the direct channel feed, but until they do, viewers will continue to move to rival satellite services for high-definition broadcasts of live sporting events such as tennis, cycling and snooker. The BBC does have the ability to increase the amount of streams during major events and has done so on numerous occasions, as follows. Generally, BBC Red Button offers text and video-based services, as well as enhanced television programs which offer extra information, video or quizzes. In September 2005, BBC launched an update to the interactivity available from the BBC's radio channels on Freeview. Originally only radio text was available. After the update, users could access information about the program, schedules, news, sport and weather. From 2005, Freeview users could access the CBBC Extra video stream. The same team behind the BBC's digital text service also launched the early incarnations of the BBC's interactive Wimbledon and interactive Open Golf service in 2000, which were awarded an interactive BAFTA that year. The news multi-screen was removed from the digital service in October 2009, to make room for future Freeview HD broadcasts. Here is a table of the contents of the BBC Red Button, last updated April 2013. The service was initially compatible with OnDigital and ITV digital boxes, though loading speeds were slower than newer Freeview boxes. Page numbers were introduced in 2004 to aid navigation, with three-digit page numbers matching with those of the analog CFAX in 2006. Pages exclusive to digital are given a four-digit number. The teletext service from the UK commercial broadcasters had stopped supporting the old boxes in 2005. As of 2010, the OnDigital boxes only load pages 100 and 199 and some interactive services that use channel 301, if any other page is loaded it exits the service. Usage of these boxes dwindled further as technology developed. They used original technology and as such were not upgradable. Following each regional changeover to full digital TV broadcasting, the remaining units are no longer of use, as they do not support the 8K mode for DVB-T introduced across the UK as part of the digital switchover. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.